Citra is an amazing Nintendo 3DS emulator, which can play most games at great performance. And in this guide, I'm going to show you how to actually download and install the Citra emulator for all your games. So first, head over to citraemu.org, and here click the big download for Windows, Linux and Mac option. Once clicked, it will all detect your platform, so for me it is Windows. If it isn't your platform or you want to download it for another platform, you can simply click right here for Mac and Linux, but for me it is Windows. So click this and you can install it pretty much anywhere you want. While this is downloading, I always recommend checking the compatibility page right here. And here you can select which games do or don't work. So the perfect and great games, these will work pretty great with great performance and not that much issues. If you move down to okay or bad playable games, the games can have some audio or graphical issues, and some might not even work in specific areas, so keep that in mind. Over here, if you click on perfect, it will select the perfect games and you can select those. And here you can select individual games, so make sure to check your game before actually trying it. So now the setup has downloaded, so open it up and let's install Citra. So click run. And here you can click next and select the directory where you want to install Citra. If it doesn't matter, just use the directory right here. But I'm going to put it in a custom directory, which is up to you. So click next. And here's a really important step if you want to install Citra Canary or Citra Nightly. I'm going to on both to show you the differences in the settings. But Canary has still experimental features that are relatively new, and Nightly has the tested features which can be a bit more stable. So Canary will have some features early, so the performance and the quality can be a bit better on Canary over Nightly, but it can be a bit more unstable. So I never had issues with Canary, so I recommend using Canary, and if that doesn't work you can drop back to Nightly. But it is up to you, do whatever you want, they both work absolutely fine. So click next and accept the licenses, and now click install and it will install for you. So in the start menu you can see Citra Nightly and Citra Canary. The installment of games will be the same for both, and once I will configure the settings I will open up both to let you see the differences between them. So first I'm going to open up Citra Canary, and right now it will ask if you want to send over data anonymously. I always recommend clicking yes, because you can improve Citra with it. But again, if you want to stay private, you can click no, it is really up to you. So once done, it will say right here, double click to add a new folder to the game list. So double click right here and select the folder where you stored all your games. The games right here needs to be a .3ds file, which needs to be decrypted. So in ROMs, I got a game Mario Kart 7.3ds. And as you can see, it is automatically added. So you can add multiple directories right here by clicking this. And if you want to install a CIA file, which is an installer file, you can also do that. Simply go to File, Install CIA, and here click the CIA you want to install. So double click it and it will install right here, and you will see the progress. Once the installment has finished, you can see installed titles right here, and I just installed Captain Toad. And once you double click any game right here, it will boot up. But first, I'm going to guide you through the settings, and I'm going to do this with both Yuzu Canary and Yuzu Nightly. So to configure your emulator, you need to click Emulation and here Configure, which I'm going to do with both. And the setup is pretty much the same for everything except some settings in graphics. But first, let's guide you through everything. Right here in general, I recommend keeping everything at default. You can change the region if you want. Over here, you can select the forum username and your token. This way you can report compatibility and also send some statistics to the website. This is up to you and you don't have to do this. In debug, I recommend leaving this at default, and the same for UI. Just leave it as it is. You can of course change anything you want, but that is up to you. In system, you can change all of this to whatever you want. You can change your username, your birthday, the language, surround sounds or stereo or mono, the country, your system clock, and you can also change the play coins, which can be useful in some games, because some games do require the play coins and you can simply add them right here. In audio, I recommend leaving this at default. The high level emulation is the fastest and you don't have to drop down to low level emulation, since there have been fixes in the high level emulation, which is absolutely amazing. For the output engine, just leave it at auto. And I always recommend using the audio stretching, because the audio can be a lot better, especially on lower frame rates. For the audio device, just select whatever you want or leave it at auto. And here you can select every volume you want. You can also use a microphone, so you can use a real device or static noise. Again, that's up to you, so you can emulate the actual microphone. In camera, you can configure a camera. Again, up to you, I leave it at default. And now there will be some differences between Canary and Nightly. So in graphics, at the left you have Canary, and at the right you have Nightly. First of all, the speed percentage should be at 100% at all times. If you change this, the game speed could vary, so leave it at 100% unless you know what you're doing. Also, always enable the hardware renderer, because this is just a lot better and otherwise it won't work properly. And over here you can select the internal resolution to whatever you want. If you increase this, it could impact performance, so keep that in mind. I'm going to put it at 5x for now. Right here, for both, enable the hardware shader. And you should leave the accurate multiplication disabled unless the forum post or whatever will tell you you should enable this, because this can reduce performance. The accurate geometry shader is automatically enabled and I recommend keeping it this way. Over here, the enable shader JIT should be enabled always, because it will be a lot faster if this is enabled. And here's the first feature which is different from Canary to Nightly. The enable linear filtering could improve some image quality in Canary, and it isn't present in Nightly at this moment. And you can enable this or disable it, which is up to you. For the post-processing shader, it is just none, which is the built-in one. And here also is a difference between Canary and Nightly. In Canary, you can select side-by-side or anaglyph 3D mode, which isn't an option in Nightly. Here you can just enable or disable it, so that's one thing to keep in mind. Over here you can increase the depth, which is up to you. Over here you can select the screen layout, which is over here in Nightly. So you can have the default, which is one screen on the top and one on the bottom. You can have a single screen, a large screen, side by side, and you can swap the screens. That's all the way up to you. And you can also change the background color. I'm going to just leave it at black, but it's up to you and it doesn't matter at all. Over here you can configure the controls, which is the same for both versions. So click the actual button and click the button on your controller to set it up. So once this is all done, click OK and you can launch whatever game you want. For example, I'm going to launch some Mario Kart 8, so let's close down Nightly. And let's open up Mario Kart 8 and it will boot up. Always click Allow Access and it will simply work. So as you can see, this game works great and many, many more games actually do work pretty great. So I hope you enjoyed this little guide. If you did, make sure to let me know by dropping a like down below and comment what you thought of it. Also consider joining any of my social media like Discord, Instagram or Twitter to stay up to date with all my videos, and I'll see you in the next video.